Hello students, today we are going to discuss the topic animal tissue from the chapter 2 of class 9th biology. As you know, the tissues in plants and animals are different because the need of the plant's body and animal's body are different. That's why the plant tissue and animal tissues are different. In the previous video, we have studied about the plant tissues, in which you have seen that the plant tissues are of two kinds, meristematic and permanent tissues. Meristematic tissues are responsible for the growth, and the permanent tissues are the tissues which have lost the capacity of cell division and have become permanent for their particular function. Here, in case of animal tissues, the tissues are different from the plant tissues, and because of the difference in their need of the life, there are totally different kind of animal tissues present in the animals' bodies. Like you can see here, the animal tissues are of four types on the basis of their function. So the first one is epithelial tissue, second one is muscular tissue, and third one is connective tissue, and the last one is nervous tissue. Epithelial tissues are the protective tissues which protect the animal's body and their organ. And the muscular tissues are responsible for the movement. Connective tissue connect the other kind of tissues together. And nervous tissues are help in the control and coordination and to transfer the message from one part of the body to another part, or you can say from the organs to the brain and from brain to the organs. So one by one we will discuss about these tissues in detail. Here in this video we will discuss the epithelial tissue only. So epithelial tissues, this term epithelial is made up of two words. One is epi, means upon, and thelio means to grow. This tissue is the simplest tissue, and that covers the entire body of the animals externally as well as internally. And the cells of the epithelial tissues are tightly packed and form a continuous sheet because they cover the surface of the animal's body and their organs. So they are tightly packed and form a continuous sheet. And they do not have any intracellular spaces and any kind of intracellular matrix. They are fitted closely. These tissues rest upon a non-cellular layer called as basement membrane, which contains a special form of matrix protein called collagen. The epithelial tissues are found on a non-cellular layer, and that layer is made up of a protein, and that protein is called collagen. Now epithelial tissues may be simple or stratified. It can be single layered, so you can say it is simple, and it can be multi-layered, so it is said stratified. It is protective tissue of animal body. The epithelial tissue is mainly responsible for the protection of the animal's body. Now they can be seen in the skin lining of mouth, in the blood vessels, in the lungs, alveoli, kidney tubules. Now there are different kind of epithelial tissues are found in the animal's body, and on the basis of the shape and function of cells, epithelial tissue is classified in different types. The first one is squamous epithelium, second one is columnar, third is glandular epithelium, fourth one is cuboidal epithelium, and Next is the ciliated epithelium. Now we will discuss one by one these types of epithelial tissue. First of all, we will discuss about the squamous epithelium, and here we will study the nature of the squamous epithelium, their occurrence and their function. So the nature of the epithelium cells are, they are composed of, this tissue is composed of single layer of thin and flat plate like cells. Here you can see in this diagram the cells of the squamous epithelium is flat and very very thin, and they look like a plate and they are square shaped and they are closely fitted together to make a continuous sheet. So the cells which are found in the squamous epithelium, they are flat and thin and they are square shaped to make a continuous sheet like structure, and they do not have any intercellular space or gap. Now these cells are resting upon the membrane, and that membrane is called basement membrane. Now where are they found? So occurrence of the epithelial tissue is surface of the skin. Our skin is made up of the upper part of our skin is made up of squamous epithelial tissues, and lining of body cavities like mouth and esophagus, lining of blood vessels and lymph vessels, and ducts of the glands. Now what is the function of the epithelial tissue, squamous epithelial tissue? So it protects the underlying part of the organ from injury, drying, entry of the germs, and it serves for easy exchange of material by the diffusion across them, for example in blood vessels and alveoli. So they help in the protection because they are making the surface of the organs and body cavities and body surface externally and internally, so they are responsible for the protection. And because they are very thin, so they serve for the easy exchange of materials. Like the blood vessels, they help in the exchange of material. Here we will discuss about the second kind of epithelial tissue, and that is cuboidal epithelium. Cuboidal epithelium is the tissue in which the cells are cube shaped and isodiametric, means their length and width are similar, same, and like the squamous epithelium, they are also closely fitted together. They have no any gap in between the cells. In the surface view, they look polygonal in shape. You can see in this diagram the cuboidal cells which are found here on the upper on the above surface. In the surface view, they are looking like polygon. Now where are they found in the animal's body? So their occurrence, they are present in the lining of kidney tubules, in the ducts of salivary glands. It also lines sweat glands, thyroid glands, and germinal epithelium of the testes and ovaries. Now what is the function? It helps in the absorption, secretion, and excretion of the substances, and it provides mechanical support. Now we will talk about the columnar epithelium. So in columnar epithelium, the cells are much longer than the broad, so they look like a pillar. So the cells which are found in the columnar epithelium, they are pillar like, and their nucleus are present in near the base at the same level. So here you can see in the diagram the cells are pillar like, they are longer than their width, and their nucleus is present at the base, and they are at the same level from each other. Now what is the occurrence, where are they found in the body? So they are found in the lining of the alimentary canal from the stomach to the rectum. As you know, the alimentary canal starts from the mouth, but from the stomach and to the rectum, the lining of the alimentary canal is formed of columnar epithelium, and the gallbladder, the bronchioles of lungs, uterine tube and uterus. So these are the organs in which the columnar epithelium is found. Now what is the function? So the columnar epithelium helps in the absorption of nutrients in the stomach and intestine and secretion of mucus from the mucus secretory glands called goblet glands. So they help in the absorption of the nutrients in the stomach and intestine. And as you know, the wall of the stomach secrete the mucus. So in the wall of the stomach there are columnar epithelium and the cells of a columnar epithelium, especially which are called goblet cells, they secrete the mucus. So this is about the columnar epithelium. Now we will talk about the ciliated epithelium. Here you can see in the diagram the cells which are found in the ciliated epithelium, they are columnar cells. They are as it is like columnar epithelium, but they have cilia over there, and that's why that epithelium is known as ciliated epithelium. So you can write that the cells of the ciliated epitheliums are columnar cells and has numerous thin delicate hair like projections called cilia from the outer surface of the cells. Because of the presence of the hair like structure that are cilia, that kind of epithelium is known as ciliated epithelium. Now occurrence, they are found in the trachea, in the bronchi, in the bronchioles, in the kidney tubules, sperm ducts and in the fallopian tubes. What is the function of this kind of epithelium? The function is the cilia which is found in this epithelium, they beat only in one direction and help to expel the mucus and dust from the lungs to the exterior. Means the because of the one way movement of the cilia, they help in the propelling the substances in the one direction. They push the substances in one direction in the pathway and help in the removal of the dust and mucus from the that organ. Now another kind of epithelium is known as glandular epithelium. So what happens here? Here some of the columnar epithelial cells of the epithelium change into glandular cells and they form the glandular epithelium. So these were the columnar epithelial cells, but they have changed their function. They become glandular and they start to produce and secrete the substances. So now they will be called as glandular epithelium. Like you can see here, they are the columnar cells, and in these columnar cells few cells have become glandular. Like you can see the goblet cell, it becomes glandular and it starts to produce and discharge the substances. Like goblet cells produce the mucus. Here what is the occurrence? They can be found in the skin, in the lining of the alimentary canal and in the pancreas. You can see the glandular epithelium in these location. Now what is the function? The function of the glandular epithelium is to secrete the hormones, sweat, saliva, enzymes and mucus. Various kind of secretory materials are secreted by the glandular epithelium, and hence that's why they are called glandular epithelium. So this is about the glandular epithelium, which helps in the secretion of hormones and sweats and saliva and various kind of secretory materials in the body. So we had discussed about the types of epithelial tissue, which are squamous, columnar, glandular, cuboidal and ciliated. So that's all about this video. In the next video we will discuss about the another kind of animal tissue, which is muscular tissue. Thank you.